Oklahoma Congresswoman Kendra Horn is hosting a civil rights and justice town hall tomorrow in Oklahoma City. And joining us this morning is the representative. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Maggie. Good to be here with you.
Thanks for being here and making time for us.
Yeah.
Let's talk about this tomorrow. This is going to be at the Fairview Baptist Church, 1 to 3.
Yes.
You'll be honoring Dr. King as well as recognizing people in Oklahoma that have made a contribution and continue to do so into the future.
Yes, especially leading up to the celebration of the life and legacy of Dr. King. We're holding this town hall to invite everyone in the community is invited and recognize the contributions of individuals in Oklahoma and their impact on civil rights and changing the face of our nation, both in the past and people that are doing the work now and looking forward to the future at what we still have yet to do. And we're going to be honoring a number of people at the town hall as well.
Open to everybody tomorrow.
Absolutely. 1 to 3 p.m.
All right, let's get right into this topic because a lot of people had something to say. You did vote for impeachment of President Donald Trump. Why?
Well, the question that was before us, as I've mentioned before, you know, I take my oath of office incredibly seriously, and upholding the Constitution is beyond partisanship, and it should always be. The questions that were in front of us were, one, an abuse of power, and two, an obstruction of Congress. About the first question, when looking at all of the evidence, the bottom line is that it is never okay for a president of any party to reach out to a foreign government and ask them to place their finger on the scales of our democracy and the most sacred part of it, our election system. That should be something that is ours as the United States. And in and of itself, that is an abuse of power. To the second question, an obstruction of Congress, this administration refused to cooperate with lawful congressional subpoenas. They refused to produce documents or allow any individuals to testify, both current and former administration officials. That's the definition of obstruction. And though I didn't come to Congress seeking this, I have to address the questions in front of me. And in my oath of office, that was, I think, the required action.
We've had lawmakers from Oklahoma on this set saying that the president did nothing wrong. When they say that, do you believe that they truly believe that? That they think that the president did not do anything wrong?
I don't know what people believe or don't believe, and I won't question their motives. But what I do know is that looking at the information, reading the transcripts, looking at the documents and the information that we have, using my training and understanding as an attorney to weigh the balance of the evidence, that the conclusion that I came down to was that that there was an abuse of power and an obstruction of Congress. And I think there's more information that we need, but that's part of the obstruction. And so I don't question others' motives because I don't think that's helpful. But I do question that we need as Congress to continue to be able to exercise our power of oversight and investigation. We've seen that through some of the work we've done in armed services with Balfour Beatty, with housing, that oversight is important. We have three co-equal branches of Congress, and that's important too.
The backlash.
Three co-equal branches, Congress, the administration, and the judiciary.
Did you hear from your constituents after that vote? Obviously, we know there were some in support, but did you hear from people that were saying, we didn't want you to vote that way?
I've heard from people on all sides of this issue, and I appreciate individuals reaching out. That's why we work so hard to be accessible. Just this last week, we were named one of the top 10 most accessible freshman members of Congress, holding a number of town halls and making sure that we're talking to people. I've heard from constituents across the 5th District on all sides of this issue, and that's why I take my time and am thoughtful with every question that comes in front of us.
Want to get to these two real quickly. Balfour Beatty, the latest on that, and then also this PFAS Action Act that you're working on.
Yeah. So with the housing issue, as I mentioned, we've been doing a lot of work on that. I'm glad that we worked in such a strong bipartisan manner to get the Tenants' Bill of Rights and the protections. But as it's been reported this week that warrants have been issued, we know that Balfour Beatty has not been a good actor. They have falsified documents and not treated our military families with respect. And this is goes down to the basic issue of housing. It is an active investigation. We know that the FBI and other departments are investigating, so there's a limited amount of things that I can say specifically, but what I can say definitively is that I will continue to fight for all of our service members and their families to ensure that they have quality housing and they are treated with the respect and dignity they deserve. And I won't rest until Balfour Beatty and other bad actors are held accountable.
And as far as this PFAS Action Act, tell us a little bit about that. We're almost out of time.
Yep, PFAS Action Act is about ensuring that we have clean and safe drinking water. PFAS are called forever chemicals. They were made to not break down in water. So they accumulate in water, in our blood supply. There are four places in Oklahoma that have tested positive, Tinker Air Force Base being one of them. The bill that we passed this last week would help to ensure testing and monitoring that is not required right now, and also a pathway to clean this up. We have to do that to ensure the health of our communities, and this was an important step in that direction, because these forever chemicals lead to cancer, impact genetic diseases and growth and development in young people, and many other things.
We thank you so much for your time this morning.
Appreciate
and look forward to hearing about the town hall tomorrow.
Yes, thank you.
All right, everyone, hang tight with us. We'll be right back after this.